That's the problem we have, is we either have starving artists or we have people who are not focused on the craft. See guys, if you don't start charging for what you do, no one will ever respect you. And the thing is, these are all self-inflicted wounds. Guys, the world is full of mediocrity. Are you mediocre is the question you need to ask yourself. It leads to places like Nikon shutting down camera bodies, laying off 1,100 people, and having major problems. We're losing the art of posing.
How do you compete with like Instagram and all these people taking photos with their iPhone?
We get in our bubble and we think that the average customer understands these things. They don't. That crowd, that new generation, my sons, they're all about apps. Those folks who make the phones are a lot smarter than the folks making cameras. They just are. Why are we spending all this money on camera gear and our shots look the same? Ask yourself that question, seriously. We are lazy and we do not maximize what our cameras can do. That is the single biggest problem in our industry. You wonder why you're broke. You're broke because you're doing what Uncle Joe can do with his phone, guys. If your shot doesn't make somebody stop, you haven't taken a good shot. Everything that I do, from the way that I edit my videos, to the way that I shoot my videos, to the way that I edit my photography work, every single thing I do is about improving my processes. And that's a lot because of what I went through with Starwood. When I was a Six Sigma, I'm a Six Sigma black belt, I'm a certified Six Sigma black belt. And that's their designation within Six Sigma. And that's when I went through all this building world-class brands. And we talked about the smells, the words. When you guys walk into hotels, they have different smells. And each hotel has the same smell. That's because your sense of smell is your strongest sense. So when you walk into a hotel and a Starwood or a Sheraton smells the same, it's not just all Starwood hotels, the W hotels, the Sheratons, you know, all of them, Aloft, St. Regis, all of them, they all have a distinctive smell. They have to be different. Their color palettes are all different. Everything's different about the hotels because they want you to connect. They want you to feel like you're coming home. Because believe it or not, when you walk into a hotel and you smell it, it triggers memories for you. And hopefully those memories are positive and that makes you want to stay there, right? We go where we're comfortable. At a certain point in time, we're all we price shop, right? I did. There was a certain point in my life where I was a big time price shopper. You know, everything was Expedia, everything. No matter what I flew, no matter where I stayed, it was all about Expedia. Those days are long gone for me. I'm not a big time luxury guy. I'm about still finding good prices and all that. But it's gonna be a Marriott and it's gonna be a Delta flight. That's the way it is. And yes, Delta infuriates me many times, as you guys may know. Why do I not switch from Delta? It's called, I have a lot of miles. And I have a lot of perks being a big time flyer with Delta. It's just a stupid thing to, it'd be easy to say, oh, just fly JetBlue or just fly United or whatever. They all have problems, so you might as well stick with the one you know. It's like having a spouse who's mediocre, but at least you know your spouse, right? Marriott, I love Marriott. I know what I'm gonna get. It has to be safe, has to be clean. And I love that, right? That's about branding. I've branded myself, it's why you guys are sitting here. It is. I could fool myself, but you're here because I've created a brand that you guys follow. Why am I telling you all of this? Because this is how you make money in photography. I assume the vast majority of you in this room would like to make money, right? What about you, brother? You want to make money? You guys want to make money, or?
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
If you don't, you should leave. Okay? Because this is not a profession that we can do lightly. Meaning this is not something that we can do and unless you're a silver, you know, spoon, trust fund baby, we need money to feed our habit. But as it relates to the branding, guys, if you're going to continue what you're doing, if you're going to continue this journey, you have to make money at it. You need to think long term when you're making your purchasing decisions, right? I always recommend, you know, here's the thing to keep in mind. I'll get in discussions on forums and people will tell me I'm wrong and I'll just chuckle and I say, okay, you want to waste your money? It's fine by me. I mean, really, it's not my money. But lenses, a great lens will last you 30, 40 years if you take care of it. A great camera body will last you 3 or 4 years if you're lucky. Not because it'll break, but because it'll be obsolete. But I do a lot of that because I YouTube and you guys want to know. So when we have a new lens come out, like the Sony 85-1.8 came out, people automatically want to know, well, how does it compare to the Batis? Well, I don't want to have to run to a camera store and borrow it. I just want to have it. So yes, it's a very expensive habit that I need to feed. So I always need to ask myself, how is this lens going to pay me back? How is this purchase going to pay me back? Who here makes money in photography? Who here wants to make money in photography? I'm here to help you guys. So I want to find out what you guys do. Because I just don't want to talk about stuff that's pertinent to me. Who cares? You guys, believe it or not, all the bravado aside, I want to help you guys. That's why I'm here. What do you guys shoot? Weddings?
I'm the proverbial uncle. Your uncle photographer is going to do your wedding? That's me.
Oh, awesome. So you get like $200 a wedding?
I do it for free because it's usually for friends.
Stop doing that. These are the mistakes we're making in the world of photography. Truly. When people say that we can't make money, we can't do X, Y, or Z, it's because we're not monetizing what we do. I have at least 6 different income streams from photography. I have a subscription service, which you all should sign up for. Okay? Patreon.com/JasonLearPhotography. That's where I do online editing. It's where I do Skype calls. It's where I critique your work. I do all of that. Right? Just different subscription levels. I get money from YouTube. I get money from speaking engagements like this. I get money from clients, wedding clients. I don't do a lot of weddings anymore. Commercial jobs, all sorts of stuff, guys. You gotta start thinking of yourself as a business and not a photographer. Different hats. And give each one 50-50. Give your artist hat 50% of your time. But that's the problem we have, is we either have starving artists or we have people who are not focused on the craft. It's rare we actually find the blend of people that get both. And honestly, to be honest, the people who are blending both are those who are successful. They really are. And I want you guys to be successful. Competition doesn't scare me. Do you know how much it was to pay a wedding photographer even 15 years ago? Like a really good wedding photographer, how much did they cost 15 years ago? Do you guys know? 6, 8, 10 grand. And those guys were popping off maybe 240 shots because it was film. So now what do we have? 15 years later, we have $1,500 weddings and we're giving them 2,500 shots. Who's the idiot? Us. We've done it to ourselves. We can blame the brides all we want. We can blame digital photography all we want. See, mirrorless is the new digital. See, these complaints have been heard before, right? Before, when all the film guys didn't want to move to digital, they went out of business. Now the digital guys don't want to move to mirrorless, they're going out of business. And if they're not out of business now, they will be. Guys, I'm here to tell you, DSLRs are on their way out. They'll be here in some way, shape, or form, but the technology is what's going to move us forward. I'm not just here to preach about Sony. I'm telling you, the technology is what's going to move your business. If you guys can't keep up with the technology, you guys are going to fail. And if you fail, that makes me sad. Who here makes their sole living off of photography or videography? Okay. Is it a comfortable living?
For now,
right? I'll hit my 10-year anniversary next month as being a pro. 10 years. I shot my first wedding in March of 2007. And when I shot that first wedding, I didn't think I'd ever be a professional photographer. I just shot it as a favor. I shot it as a favor, and I charged them $2,500. And I had no idea what I was doing. Truly. But I felt like I could do it. See, guys, if you don't start charging for what you do, no one will ever respect you. Ever. And ever. And you guys keep hearing me, it's money, money, money. Guys, if you don't have the money, you're not going to have the gear. If you don't have the gear, you're not going to create great results. We can go out, I can take the same shot, you and I can be standing side by side. If I have a $2,000 lens, you have a $200 lens, I get a better shot every time. Every time. There's no two ways around it. don't try to delude yourself, confuse yourself, anything into thinking that that $2,000 lens is the same as a $200 lens. It's not. It's absolutely not. I'm not here to push you. I'm here to help you understand. You know why? I've sat in your shoes and I've seen my shots and I'm like, why do his shots look so good and mine don't? I suck. It's not always you, guys. It's not. It wasn't until 3, 4, 5 years ago that I actually really started getting into great lenses. Truly. I didn't have a lot of money. I didn't. I left my hotel executive job that I was making easy six figures, having a great time. Left it and to become a wedding photographer. What an idiot. Right? And I did it right when the market was tanking. Seriously, I did it right as the market. The huge crash happened in what, 2007, 2008? Well, that's when I decided to leave my cushy job that I had worked over a decade to get and become my own entrepreneur to do photography. Best decision I've ever made, but the timing was interesting. You know how many times people tell me, oh, I'd love to do what you do, but no one's gonna hire me. Are you serious? Hustle. I can't stand those kinds of comments. I can't stand them. You're not thinking outside the box. I made myself who I am. I wanted to be a destination wedding photographer. I went on, it's no longer around. I think it's called Wedfolio now. I went on to wedplan.net, started looking up so-and-so's getting married. If it was a cute girl, cute dress, cute venue, I shot it. Oh, it shouldn't matter. Are you guys serious? It's called branding, guys. It's called marketing. I'm trying to be straight with you guys. This is what matters. If you want to make it in the world. Guys, we're a visual medium. You guys got to get that. I am tired of people not being able to be successful. And the thing is, these are all self-inflicted wounds. Will I shoot big people, small people, ugly people, beautiful people? Of course I will. Do I charge ugly people more than I charge beautiful people? No, I don't. It's funny, but I don't. But what I'm saying is, when you're building your portfolio, when you're building your brand, build it wisely. Build it wisely. Go out. The shoot that I did on the Salt Flats, have you guys seen that shoot with the girl, the ballerina? I went to Savers, because that was at the Bonneville Salt Flats. I went to Savers and I bought a wedding gown. We put clips on her, and she went, and she was a dancer, and we started doing shots. I wanted to create something epic, something somebody would look at my shots and say, that's different. I want that, right? Guys, the world is full of mediocrity. Are you mediocre is the question you need to ask yourself. Truly. If you're not asking yourself that question, just get out of the business. And find something that you are not okay being mediocre at. I am the guy, I'm the person who pushes people. Ask my team. I don't accept it. I don't accept mediocrity. I don't, because I don't accept it of myself. If you're not willing to work harder than anybody else, get out. Get out. Stop making excuses. Here I am chewing you guys out and I barely know you. But seriously, guys, I want you guys to understand this stuff. It's important. It's vital for you guys to be successful. Because I see our industry, when you see somebody like Nikon and they're failing, and yes, they are failing. Do I know if they're going to go out of business? No, I don't. Do I hope they go out of business? No, I hope they don't.
Kodak will never go out of business.
2.5 years ago, I did my 10 Reasons video.
Oh, you just wait till Nikon and Canon come out with their full frame mirrorless.
That was the dumbest move those two companies ever made. They let Sony become a powerhouse. They let it happen, and it happened. It's like watching somebody steal away your wife, and you're like, I'm watching it happen, and I'm doing nothing about it. They literally, 5 years ago, I was at a workshop. I started teaching workshops about 4 or 5 years ago. I'm teaching workshops 4 or 5 years. I was in West Virginia, and a girl named Missy Swecker, she comes up to me. We're still friends. And she hands me her Sony DSLR. And I was that guy, okay? She gave me the Sony and I'm like, oh. She's like, what? It's a really good camera. And I'm like, no. Be gone, Satan, right? And I'm looking at the camera and I'm like, that's a Sony. It was almost like repellent. Nobody gave Sony the time of day. Let's just be honest. Let's just be real, okay? Sony A-mount, they have some fantastic stuff. Nobody cared. When I say nobody, there's always gonna be that one guy, oh, I've been shooting Sony since 1918. Okay, that's awesome. But you were not the reason Sony was successful, right? Sony, the best thing they ever did was come out with A6000. A6000 was a game changer. I never thought that little midget camera would get me to switch. Never. Got that camera in my hands, started shooting with it, and yes, I was just using kit lenses at the time. I took it to Ethiopia, I took it to Detroit, did all my shoots. Some of you guys have seen those shoots online. And about 6 weeks later, I'm like, this is a real kick butt little camera. So then I really dove in. And if you guys don't know, this is what I don't do it as much now, but backtrack time machine about 3 years ago, 2.5 years, about 3 years ago. I lay in bed and I'm on the B&H app looking for used items, right? So I'm looking for cameras and I see the A7S. And I was going to Niagara Falls. And I'm like, ooh, this should be cool. And then I'm thinking, okay, I'm gonna buy this. It's like $1,800. I gotta make sure it arrives when my wife isn't home. sure enough, it came in. And I, you know, there were no good lenses, just to be real, for Sony at the time. So I bought a Rokinon, Nikon mount, used an adapter on it, formerly known as Photo Deox, the devil, Chucky. And if you don't know why, it's because Photo Deox blew up one of my cameras. But I took that, it was a manual adapter, so it didn't destroy my camera. And I took that to Niagara Falls and shot with it, and I'm like, this is a really killer camera. I'd never seen a camera, because previous to that, I'd always told people who would come to my workshops, I'd always told them, guys, look, Nikon and Canon both make great gear. And this is the way that I would differentiate between the two at the time. I would say Canon's better for video work. Nikon's better for stills. That's the way I would differentiate it about 3 years ago. Because I would say, and it was true, I mean, Canon had Magic Lantern, Canon had, you know, a focus peaking. They really geared themselves more towards the video market. Nikon had an edge with ISO sensitivity. You could get better ISO results out of Nikon cameras. And because of that, I would recommend to people, if you're stills, I'd go Nikon. If you're video, I'd go Canon. Sony came out and they said, okay, here, you want focus peaking? You got it. You want zebra? You got it. You want focus magnification? You got it. Pretty much whatever you want, you got it. We'll give it to you. You want low light? You got it. And then Sony, guys, I'll be candid with you. Sony didn't even know this was going to take off. Seriously. I mean, how could you have predicted that a company that had competed, you know, so first it was Minolta, then Sony bought Minolta, and then Sony comes along, and they had competed against Canon and Nikon for years, and honest, let's just be real, they really hadn't made a dent. I mean, it was a very small niche of people who shot it, right? And then mirrorless just went, literally. And why did I choose Sony over Panasonic, Olympus, Fuji, all those guys? There's one simple answer, full frame. Like I can't take you serious if at least you don't offer a full frame. Yes, I love the crop sensor Sonys, but I have to have me a full frame. I have to. If you've shot with an A7 R2, it's hard to shoot anything else. That camera is addicting, right? Then the A7S II comes out, A7 R2 comes out, A7 II comes out, all these cameras come out, and before you know it, Nikon and Canon have a big problem on their hands. Nikon was the first mirrorless. See, here's the problem with Nikon, right? And I say this as somebody who, I watched my dad shoot Nikon for 30 years. So it's actually painful for me to talk about Nikon. But Nikon was the first, you know, they were the first to come out with a video DSLR, the D90. And then what did they do? We were the first. Then Canon goes, and we're much better. Nikon was the first to come out with mirrorless. You can't take them serious. They made them for prosumers. They never imagined that professionals would dare to actually use mirrorless cameras. They weren't bold. See, the way that I'm speaking to you guys right now is bold, unafraid. Those are the people that rise to the top. Those are the companies that rise to the top. Nikon was timid. We'll always come out with something, but we'll just kind of half-step it. Don't half-step it, jump. And that's really what I'm saying. Again, all of them make great stuff. Olympus, Panasonic, guys, they all make great gear. They all do. I'm not here bashing any camera brand, I'm not. What I'm saying is the technology is the problem. It's not really the hardware as more as it is the software. You know, Sony really, and other mirrorless cameras do as well, they're adapting to the future. They're adapting with now. They're putting apps on the phones. It's that adaptation to current technology that's enabling them to surpass these companies that don't have it, guys. So looking at the room, I think most folks are in the 25 to 45, 50 age range, I guess would be safe to say. You know, but if you're looking at millennials, when they decide to actually start working and being productive in society, sorry to the millennials out there, you're clearly not in that group because your other millennials are right now getting high somewhere. There's always exceptions. A few of you are sitting in this room. I've employed some of them, and that's why I have such strong feelings. It's all about me. Where's my safe zone? I feel so triggered right now. I had an employee tell me, you're infringing on my social media. You're infringing on my social life. I went back into my memory bank, and I thought, have I ever, or would I ever have been dumb enough to have ever said that to one of my bosses? Hey boss, you're really cramping down my social life. I said it once, yeah, said it once and out the door, right? It's ridiculous. But when the millennials actually decide to contribute to society, those said millennials, you guys are laughing in the back. We got some good millennials in here. I'm gonna keep pushing you millennials until you guys hit, you know, keep going and put down the bong and start working. But, never putting down the bong? Okay. What I'm saying is that crowd, that new generation, my sons, they're all about apps. They're all about technology. They're all about now. You know, when I first switched, I can remember very well when I first switched about, oh, we don't need to be able to transfer pictures instantaneously. That's a stupid feature. How many people made fun of my 10 Reasons video? Oh, that's so stupid. Who needs that? Okay, go ahead. Keep saying I'm stupid. Go ahead. Here I am, and I'm making money, and you're not. That's not bragging. That's just reality. You're at a wedding. You guys are trying to transfer an image. You got everyone at the wedding taking pictures with their cell phones. And you're sitting there thinking, oh, what does it matter? My picture's 10 times better. A, keep telling yourself that. It's probably not true. B, time is money, guys. Social media age, it's on Snapchat, Facebook, Instagram. Flickr's dead. But it's on those, right? All over the place. And probably some other social media platforms that I'm too old to know exist. Right? They're out there. And then you're sitting there and you're uploading and posting your pictures 10 days later. Right? Nobody cares. Even the bride doesn't care. Because you're not keeping up with times. Nikon came out with SnapBridge, right? Transfer their images. User reviews on SnapBridge says it blows. Do they fix it? No. Why not? Not listening to your customers. Sony listens. Big complaint. There's no lenses. No lenses. Camera bodies are pretty cool. There's no lenses. We cannot possibly consider the system unless there's lenses. I said they're going to come out with lenses. Not because I consult with Mount Sony over in Japan. I don't. It's just common sense. I'm like, well, they'd have to or they're not going to exist. Now they have 21 full-frame lenses for their E-mount system, native lenses. Then they said, oh, now the lenses are here, but they're too expensive. I said, oh, they'll come out with the cheap ones. How do you know? Well, they have to, because not everybody's a Leica shooter, right? Not everybody's rich. They're coming out with the cheap lenses. Whatever it is that you guys do, think about, are you planning for tomorrow or are you stuck on today? Brenda, how often do we talk about the future?
All the time.
Do Do you get sick of it? Good answer. See, she's a smart girl. Okay. I'm always talking about where we're going to be. I was at WPPI and one of my buddies, Josh, said to me, did you really think you'd be here in 5 years? 5 years ago, talking to the Jason 5 years ago, did you really think you'd be where you are today? I said, absolutely. People think that's cocky. That's not cocky, it's belief. There's a difference. Arrogance is when you refuse to help others. Arrogance is when you think you're better than others. I don't think I'm better than others, I just work hard. I don't think I'm better than anybody in this room. But he asked me, are you satisfied? Do you think you'll be somewhere? I said, oh, I'll be so much further ahead in 5 years than I am now. That's the way I believe. If I'm not moving ahead, then stagnation is the worst thing that can happen to any person, any company, anything. It leads to places like Nikon shutting down camera bodies, laying off 1,100 people, and having major problems. Major problems. So who shoots Nikon? You guys go like this. I still love Nikon. I still love it. And I'm glad there's Nikon shooters here. I'm not here to put you down. I'm really not. I'm a Nikon shooter. I always consider myself to be a Nikon shooter. I shot it. It's what I fell in love with. And it would break my heart if they go out of business. I hope they don't. I'm not saying they will. But I hope they get with the times. Right? Canon came out with a mirrorless camera. I was in Germany at Fotokina, and a Canon came up to me. I was doing a photo walk. There's like 20 of us outside, and Canon walks up, and they said, hey, can we interview you? And I'm like, are you sure you want to interview me? Like, yeah, we want to interview you. I said, really? You know who I am? Oh, yeah, we want to interview you. I said, okay, what do you think of the new Canon mirrorless, whatever that thing is? And I said, well, it's like an A6000. Welcome to, 2014. I don't think they ever posted that video. Okay? Again, guys, stop. At some point, you gotta catch up and then start to jump. So I do hope that Canon and Nikon come out with some full-frame mirrorless. I've heard it for the last 3 years, and it still hasn't come true. I think that, you gotta imagine just how much back stock they have of lenses and bodies, right? That they don't want to become obsolete, because that's really what you're doing. You're asking them to completely, say, we can't use this stuff anymore. That's the real problem.
How do you compete with Instagram and all these people taking photos with their iPhone and then getting weddings and doing it, lowballing them? How does a photographer compete with that? Because they're like, oh, well, I can get this guy and he'll do it for $500. But he just takes a photo and then slaps a filter on it. But all his wedding photos look the exact same.
Yes, that's a big problem in these days, right? What do our camera bodies do, regardless of platform? All of the stuff I said about Nikon, I want to make it clear. They make great stuff. They just need to get up to date. It's great stuff. Canon, same thing, okay? So we're talking about the big three, Canon, Nikon, Sony. What do those cameras do that iPhones can't do? Depth of field is one.
Zoom lenses.
Zoom without digital crop, which is losing resolution. Uh-huh.
Low light.
Low light, right?
Well, they're cameras made for photography, not a phone with a photo op on it.
Agreed. But here's what we need to, here's the mistake we make as photographers. We get in our bubble. Okay, and this is important. I'm about to preach to you guys. We get in our bubble and we think that the average customer understands these things. They don't. They only see what they see on IG. For the old people in the room, that's Instagram. Okay? Don't feel bad. Someone had to teach me that too. Okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay? I remember I was with the model and she's like, oh, I'm going to post this on IG. And I'm like, oh, what's IG? Is that a new one I need to get on? That's Instagram, Sally. Okay, thanks. I love that the young folks in the crowd are laughing. That actually brings me joy. It brings me hope for the future. I'm totally right, yeah. Yeah, you young guys are dang lazy. Not you in the room. Because clearly you're here. And yes, there's lazy old people too, but the millennials are taking it to a whole new level. well, talking about millennials, what you're hiring, millennials are getting married, unfortunately. They're reproducing. Okay? Since millennials are getting married and they've grown up on phones, they've grown up on all this stuff. I'm gonna get so much hate for this video. But they've grown up and they're doing all this, and then they see the Instagram filters. This is an important part, all jokes aside. They see the Instagram filters, they see all this stuff. It's understandable that they want that. See, we don't give them a different offering. If you think of it this way, they're on an island and all they see is one brand of car, and I think that brand of car is pretty good. All of a sudden, somebody sneaks over the wall with a brand new car. Car's like, wow, this is really different. I don't see this a lot. They're driving that car around, all of a sudden it piques interest. You know how many people have hired me saying, I didn't know you could expose for the skies? How do you get your fake shots? If you don't focus on what your gear can do for you that the average gear cannot do, you're going to fail. You're going to make $500 at a wedding. You will plateau. You will never make more, ever. Because the camera phones are constantly getting better. Constantly. They've added panoramics and 360s and HDR and everything under the sun they add. Because guess what? Those folks who make the phones are a lot smarter than the folks making cameras. They just are. I'm not talking IQ smarter, I'm talking street smart. They're like, well, this is what the kids want, let's give it to them. They see that the pro cameras can create these beautiful dynamic range shots, so they, okay, let's just add HDR into the phones. Now everyone's running around. HDR pick, they're like, look at your stupid camera. You're an idiot, you spent $5,000 on that, I spent $500 on mine. Honestly, they're right, we're stupid. We are dumb. Why are we spending all this money on camera gear and our shots look the same? Ask yourself that question, seriously. Why are we spending all this money, extra money, 5-10 times the amount, and our shots look the same? Who is the problem here? Is it all the kids running around putting Instagram filters on the pictures, or is the problem us? It's us. Why? We are lazy. And we do not maximize what our cameras can do. That is the single biggest problem in our industry. Single biggest problem. Our cameras can do high-speed sync. Can crappy little iPhones do high-speed sync? No. Yet, the vast majority of our industry shoots all natural light. And you wonder why you're broke. You wonder why you're broke. You're broke because you're doing what Uncle Joe can do with his phone, guys. That's why you're broke. Oh, my lens flare. That is the stupidest crap. Okay, you look at wedding websites, it's all the same. All daytime pictures at magic hour, and they still screw up magic hour, and it's all blown out white skies. Seriously, and you wonder why you can't make money. You're not making money because your shots don't look any different. If your shots aren't different, you ain't gonna make money.
I just want to say that you're right, because I do the things that I do, and I think outside the box, and I've been working with my lighting, people have been messaging me out of the blue and trying to hire me for jobs, because it's something that other people don't do.
It is, right? Yep. Sandra's, she's been following me around for a while. She drove from Massachusetts to be here today. Like, she straight up drove just for this. That's pretty awesome. So I love you. But it is true, guys. Our cameras, what is it that we can do different? High speed sync. Let's just say you don't want to get crazy and you just do off camera flash. Forget about high speed sync. Off camera flash. Can your phones do off camera flash? Why are you guys doing what everyone can do when you should be doing what everyone can't? That is, I could care less what gear you buy. If you guys let that sink in today and you get the gear that you need that is relevant to that statement, you are going to start making more money. This shot's A7S II, right? You're not gonna get this shot with an iPhone. Why? The A7S II has the best ISO performance in the world, right? Off-camera flash, LED lighting. Guys, these are the things that make your shots look different. The depth of field. This was shot with a Zeiss Batis, right? The bokeh in it, how it renders. washes out that background. You guys want to have professional looking shots, start using wide aperture lenses. Why in the world do you guys buy a wide aperture lens and shoot it at 2.8, 3.5? Why? You just wasted a ton of money. I'm here to tell you. Stop getting these lenses that are, oh, it's a 1.2, but it's sharp at 2.8. You just got sold a bill of goods, my friend. Seriously. You just got tricked. Right? You guys need to start utilizing all of these things that make your shots different. I love walking up to an iPhone person, Android too, I'm not just hating on iPhones, and I pull up my shot and I take a picture of that sexy dude sitting right there, and my shot, it washes away the background, right? I have a great focus to defocus from him to the background, right? iPhone can't do that. And my workshops, this is something I'll teach you guys too. That was the A7S. I wouldn't get that shot with an iPhone. I have better ISO sensitivity, right? Start thinking of your gear as a tool for you guys to make money, right? If you think about it that way, you guys will start making better purchasing decisions. How is this gear going to get me something that nobody else can do? Nobody else in my area. Yep.
I think I'm not a photographer. I come from the advertising industry, but one thing from my perspective that's important to mention is that while the gap in technology between your cameras and iPhones is maybe closing, what we hire for is consistency of quality. And someone with an iPhone has a lucky shot, but they can't deliver a campaign of consistent quality of images, and that's why we hire professionals like you, because we can rely on you to deliver the same quality across the whole campaign.
That's very true, and I appreciate that statement. The unfortunate part to that is the ad agencies out there are few and far in between. So you're absolutely, I completely 100% agree with you. And I do commercial work and I work with ad agencies, but for the average photographer, they never sniff an ad agency. They don't. And so they have to, the consistency, I want to make it clear, I completely agree with you. But most folks will never shoot for an ad agency. And I love that I do. We should talk. But go after it, guys. I sniff out money like a dang bloodhound. Relative to his statement about the iPhone pictures and the Instagram pictures, it is a problem that is completely wiping through. It's like a plague coming through our industry. It's like the walking dead, right? Coming through our industry, and we can't get ahead. We can't get out of it. We feel like we're stuck. We feel like we can't make money. Guys, the only way you're going to make money is if you look different. If your shot doesn't make somebody stop, you haven't taken a good shot. Seriously. We are bombarded with images every second of every day, right? Instagram, billboards, TV, image, 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 image. It's only those images that you're like, whoa, that's pretty cool. How many people have just gone and watched a movie just based off a poster from a trailer? Just a movie poster. You're like, I may want to go check that out. Right? I know it works with me. Right? You see it and you're like, wow, that looks pretty cool. At the bare minimum, I'm going to YouTube the trailer and see if it's any good. Right? It was the image that made me want to do it. If it's a bland image, you're like, there's a million movies. Hollywood has the same problem. They have to compete with the Netflixes of the world. So if they don't utilize the tools that make their movies that much better, they're going to be out of business. They won't make money. Same thing, guys. So how to compete? You got to have results that look different. What's another thing that iPhoneographers, and I'm sure there's some fantastic, famous iPhoneographer out there that somebody's going to send me links to their person. Okay, that's fine. It's, believe me, it's one in a million. There's always an exception. There always is an exception, but it's the one or two in a million. Okay? Another thing that folks don't learn is posing. Okay? We're losing the art of posing. And that, oh, just go stand there. I love watching photographers, just go stand there. What do you mean go stand there? They're not gonna pose themselves. They can't see themselves. Now, very experienced models like Brenda, I've worked with her so much, yeah, I have to tell her to tone it down at the workshops. Tone it down. Tone it, not in a bad way. Tone it down. Tone it down meaning she'll pose herself. And the photographers are going crazy. They're like, oh, this is awesome. Like if you guys watch my videos, I've shot so much with Jade and Allie and Brenda and some of them that when they watch, they'll go through the whole routine that we do. And then the attendees are getting great shots. And I want them to get great shots, but I also want the attendees to do it so they learn it. So I'll have to tell Brenda, okay, just stand there like a twig, make them pose you. Then when we get into the posing, that's another thing that separates you. Your lenses separate you. Your posing separates you. Your lighting separates you. Okay? And lighting is by far the biggest differentiator of them all. People hire me just because of my lighting. People watch my videos because of my lighting. I'd like to think it's my charming personality. I don't think that's the case.
Okay.
You agree? Guys, what it really boils down to is making yourself different. If you don't make yourself different, you're going to just be in the herd. You're not going to be successful. And I'm not trying to make this a downer talk. I'm trying to make this something where you guys actually change who you are and what you do. Does that make sense? I'm not here to insult you. I'm not here to put you down. I'm here to help you out of that rut. Right? Because guys, ultimately, back to what I started saying, if you want to make money, you got to be better. Who here uses off-camera flash? Awesome. That's a good Fedora Nation crowd right there. I shot the earlier, not that hippo, I didn't shoot that with the flash, but I shot that Snow Queen shoot in Austin, Texas, shot that with the Broncolor Mobi LEDs. Awesome lights. Two problems. You got to plug them in and have a huge car battery. Two, they're like $3,000 by the time you add all the stuff to it. It's hard for me to justify just so I can make myself feel better saying I'm a Broncolor shooter when I can just put a flash point up there, put a little beauty dish on it and fire. It's hard to justify that, y'all. I'm here to break it down. The light's not, it's not that much different. And I'm not sponsored by them. What they've done is they've released these brand new, new in maybe 6 months, a year, but they've released these monolights that now enable the average photographer, and I consider myself that, the average photographer can afford. That's a game changer. Why? Because it used to be only the pros could get the shots that look different from the iPhones. Now you guys can all get those shots. See here, that's the way I want you guys to think. How can we move ourselves into gear that makes our shots better, that makes us money? This domino effect, right? We're gonna work with some of this gear. The Rotolighter Nova Pro. It's the first professional LED light that strobes. High-speed sync flash, no recycle time. Again, doing things that other people cannot do is what's gonna separate your work and make you money. I really wanted to focus today on how you guys can make money. Where are we going next week?
Cuba.
Who's paying for it?
You.
Right. Who's paying for everything we do? I pay for it all. Everything. Sony doesn't fly me to Cuba. Y'all think that's the way sponsorships work? Y'all are crazy. Okay. Do I get paid to speak today? Absolutely. Should I be paid to speak today? Absolutely. I'm worth it. And you guys should say the same about yourselves. Live your dreams. I wanted to shoot the pictures you saw like of the hippo. That was a self-funded trip to South Africa. National Geographic's just not gonna pick up the phone and call you guys. I go to Kruger, I rent a Nissan Versa, and I drive all over the place. Spend 3 weeks there. That's what I wanna do when I'm in Kruger National Park, right? What paid for my trip to Kruger National Park? Weddings.
Oh. I want to be a photographer, but I don't want to shoot weddings or kids or pets. Good luck. I want to sell my landscapes like Peter Lick. Good luck.
People, I love landscape photography. It's what gets a lot of us into photography. It's what got me into photography. But landscape photography, there's a very tiny, tiny market to sell your prints and to actually make a good living. Tiny market. We're going to show you a few things that will immediately improve your work. You guys see me play around with this eye lighter in my videos? $250, it will change your photography. Do iPhones usually have great catch light? No. Bingo. Let's talk about the things where you guys can be different. All right, guys, we're going to take a quick break, give you guys a potty break. We're going to come back. We're going to get right into the gear, get refreshed, and then we'll come back in 20 minutes, and then we will start with all of the gear, all of the lighting, posing, and everything. If you guys have questions, let me know. You guys still here? Hello? Talking to you. Hey guys, if you want to learn online with me, go to patreon.com/JasonLanierPhotography and you will be able to continue this craziness online from anywhere on planet Earth with me. If you want to join me live, go to JasonLanier.com/workshops and you'll get to see me in my full glory live and in person, guys. I think there's a smudge on there. Is that it? Yeah, I got it. Talk to you later, guys. Bye.